SmackDown Here Comes the Pain was released in 2003, and it is honestly probably the greatest wrestling game of all time, the fifth SmackDown game, and in most eyes, a perfect wrestling game. See, Here Comes the Pain represented 5 games of growth. What started in PlayStation 1 in the year 2000 with SmackDown 1 reached its climax and its peak with SmackDown Here Comes the Pain in 2003. It was 5 games of evolution. It was literally everything that the fans wanted in a wrestling game. But it was also the end. In 2004, it was announced that there was not going to be a SmackDown 6. It was done. The SmackDown series had lived a glorious, glorious life. But it was all over. But at least it went out on top, on some Tupac shit. So the question that was on every wrestling fan's mind, what was gonna take its place? How do you follow up something like Here Comes the Pain, arguably the greatest wrestling game of all time? See, Aki never had the chance to follow up No Mercy, but now all these years later, THQ and Yukes were gonna try to follow up Here Comes the Pain with another classic, which is definitely easier said than done. See, the hype for this game was insane. I began looking back at forums from 2004 of people discussing this game before it came out, and it was just so fascinating. People were really, really excited for this. They had the same question, how are they going to follow up the beloved Here Comes the Pain? And a lot of people actually had suggestions. People started discussing online what they wanted in the game almost a full year before it came out. In November of 2003, literally the same month that Here Comes the Pain came out. So one user back in June of 2004 said he wanted create a finisher. He was 4 years too early. Another user wanted downloadable cause, and this poor guy was 5 years too early. But people were intrigued and they were excited. And then IGN dropped this teaser video. And ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the most fire teaser trailers I've seen for anything.
Generations. Much can be learned from past generations. For past generations write history. They become history. The past may have already been written. But the future awaits a new generation.
Oh my God! It's SmackDown versus Raw! Sports entertainment will never be the same!
There is no way that you can tell me after seeing that trailer that you wouldn't be hyped for this game. It's impossible. So, it was time for the next generation. SmackDown series had a great run, but it was time to move on. So in November of 2004, it was a new beginning. The iconic SmackDown vs. Raw series was created. Everybody knew that it was going to be a transition year, but there were still a lot of questions. What were they going to add? What were they taking away? Was the game still going to be fun? Or were wrestling games on the PlayStation as we knew them done, and it was time for something totally different? So, let's go back, let's pretend it's 2004, let's put on our oversized G-Unit shirts, and let's take a look back at the first SmackDown vs. Raw. So first things first, one thing that I love about this game right from the start is the menu selection. It's simple, are you Team SmackDown or Team Raw? See, as a kid personally, I was always a SmackDown guy to be honest. How about you guys though? Leave a comment on what team you were on growing up. So the thing is, whatever team you decide, that's how your menu looks. But let's be real, the SmackDown menu looks so much cleaner. One of the first things that you'll notice when this game starts is the music. Yes, music. Not the typical SmackDown music you're used to in the games that always sounded exactly the same every single year, but actual licensed music. Yes, the SmackDown games starting from this series all the way until 2011-ish are filled with absolute bangers. Just so many amazing songs, so many bands I discovered because of these games, and it all started here. Technically Day of Reckoning, but you know what I mean. Some of the bangers on the soundtrack include Worlds Collide by Power Man 5000. Fireflies by Breaking Benjamin. Superstars by Styles of Beyond. Hey yo, first things first, it's time to shake ground in the eighth round. Box battle will break down for the beak and the round tone. Jump in the cyclone, S-T-Y-L-E-S, yes, I know. and just so much more. Like I said, so many great bands and artists were discovered by millions of people because of this game. This game's soundtrack is just iconic, and it adds so much to the game. The music fits the game perfectly, but it also just fits the time period well too, so it's a match made in heaven. The match types are generally the same from Here Comes the Pain, which isn't a bad thing because Here Comes the Pain basically had every match you could possibly want. From three stages of hell, to an elimination chamber, to a hell in a cell, it was there and it was covered. But now let's talk about something that actually hurts this game. And ladies and gentlemen, that is the roster. Here Comes the Pain had an amazing deep roster. This game though, it's lacking, to say the least. Mostly due to the part that in real life, a lot of people just left the company. So Stone Cold left, Brock Lesnar, Goldberg, and even people who weren't the most popular wrestlers in 2003 but still helped make the roster more stacked, like Scott Steiner and Kevin Nash. It just lost a lot of depth. So, you know, we still have Angle, Triple H, Michaels, and Eddie, and all the big time players from 2004, but then we also just get a bunch of people like Chuck Palumbo. It just lacked depth, and overall it does affect the game negatively. However, in one way the game did improve over Here Comes the Pain was the legends. So legends were introduced in Here Comes the Pain, and they are back, but now we actually get people that we actually want to use. Oh, and some guy named Bret Hart. Wait, did you say Bret Hart? Yes, Bret Hart made his return to wrestling games in 2004, and SmackDown vs. Raw was the second game back, but the first on the PlayStation. His first WWE game appearance on the PlayStation since WWF Warzone in 1998. And fans were legit so excited that he was in the game. Just look at the reactions on the forums from 2004, and it was definitely an amazing addition. As this user said, oh, buying it first day, Bret Hart equals instant buy. But like I said, even then, the roster is still the main issue with this game. The roster is just small, it lacks depth. There are only 52 characters in total, including 2 Takers, 2 Canes, and fucking Garrison Cade. But thank God for a creator wrestler. Speaking of creation, we got a feature that people had wanted forever. Create a championship. And the create a championship mode is pretty sweet. You gotta give credit where credit is due. They put a lot of detail into that mode, especially for a game that came out in 2004. I love it. Straps, centerpiece, nameplate, whatever you want to edit, you can do it. Only issue is, it's expensive as a motherfucker. So if you want to make a belt, you better start grinding this game like it's Battlefront 2. Okay, it's not that bad. So, you got create a belt, match types are all there, roster is okay, it could have been much worse, okay. The music is fire, but how's the actual wrestling in the wrestling? How is the gameplay? Well, first off, the entrances are great, and we finally got Eddie Guerrero's lowrider. I love it. He actually drives it all the way to the ring. The game just looks great as well. The graphics are upgraded once again, and it just looks nice and sharp. So the goal for this game by Yukes was to make the WWE experience a little bit more realistic than past games. So when the match starts, in singles matches, you find yourself in a mini game. It could be a test of strength, a stare down contest, or whatever. It's just nice. It's a nice way to start a match, other than the typical, let me press triangle, run all the way across the ring, and do a running grapple, take him down, and just start beating him up. You know, it makes the matches more realistic. Another thing is the game looks darker, meaning the lighting is darker, which isn't a bad thing, but I personally prefer like brighter lighting, but it's not that serious. The gameplay is pretty similar to Here Comes the Pain, but it is slowed down a bit, but in a good way. The flow of the matches are improved without a doubt. The gameplay here is pretty fire. It's still similar enough that it's not a drastic change, but it feels just a little bit more polished. I love the new features that they added to the gameplay. They're not the biggest features, they're pretty small, but it's still pretty cool. Like you can get into a chop battle, you can hold a rope break until the 4 count, remove torn buckles, complain to the referee, just little touches that make the game more realistic, but still not sacrificing the fun arcadey gameplay that it has. So in this game, they introduced a different way to play. You can play clean, neutral, or dirty. So if you choose to play clean, you're basically a face, and you have a clean meter, which goes up if you do things that a face would do. So you know, just doing your special moves, your normal moves, high flying moves, and taunting. And when your meter is up, you do a special taunt, and your character basically goes into Super Cena mode and becomes invincible, and your finisher does like 1,000 more damage than normal. Okay, not 1,000, but it does more damage. Whereas if you're dirty, you gotta do dirty things, such as things I mentioned before, like holding the ropes until the four count, removing the turnbuckle, complaining to the referee, using weapons until you fill up your meter, you do a taunt, and then you get the deadliest, dirtiest special move of all time, a super powered low blow. It's cool, it adds another dimension to the game, so when you're facing a computer, it kinda makes things more realistic, so heels do heel things instead of fighting like every other wrestler. So if you're versing Triple H and this is 2004 and he's a heel, he will fight like a heel and not just a regular wrestler. See, the thing is, this game is pretty polarizing, but it's hard to find someone who can hate on the gameplay in this game. What you can hate on though is that there are no post-match celebrations. The match just ends. What the fuck? So it's like you have this epic ass match, people are dying, there's blood everywhere, a championship is crowned, and it just asks, do you want a rematch or do you want to quit? Like my bad, alright? That definitely takes away from the experience. One other thing that makes me sad is, rest in peace to the backstage mayhem from Shut Your Mouth and Here Comes the Pain. So there is a backstage area and there's even a parking lot now. But there are no more random ass places, there's no more exploring, there's no more New York City, no more subway, no more locker room area. It's just one large area and one parking lot. But those are two different matches, so you can't travel. That also kinda hurts. But still, the parking lot brawl is pretty lit. Just look at the crazy stuff that you can do. It's very interactive and it's very cool. And so is the backstage area. But the thing is, I just miss the freedom. I miss being able to go wherever I want, whenever I want. Now you're kinda just confined to these two areas and it does get old pretty quick. So let's talk about the season mode, cause back then, season mode, career mode, whatever you wanna call it, actually mattered in wrestling games. It's good. It's not the worst, it's not the best, but you'll still have fun. But in my opinion, it still is a downgrade from Here Comes the Pain, but almost every season mode is. The season mode is cool because we got voice acting, even though the character that you use doesn't talk, everyone else does. But it's fine, it's not the end of the world. And plus, SmackDown vs. Raw 2006 fixed that. Now listen, it's not the best voice acting, but trust me, just having voice acting back then was cool enough for us. The story mode is much more linear now, and that is because of the voice acting, but you can still make decisions and it is still fun. I'll be honest with you, you'll have fun playing season mode. It's the 2004 WWE Universe captured in a video game form, so you do get some pretty cool storylines and you'll have some fun, especially if you were watching during this time. You got Eric Bischoff, you got Paul Heyman, you got Kurt Angle just doing crazy stuff. It's 2004 WWE. It also does get kinda rowdy, especially when you fight for Trish's contract at WrestleMania and it's a ladder match. And instead of like a championship or a briefcase or even a contract, they hang Trish's panties. Yeah, you heard me right. It's a welcome addition and another great season mode, but I still miss the free roaming from Shut Your Mouth so much. And honestly, that's about it. I mean, the game had online when it came out, but it was really basic. I mean, it didn't mean anything. But as an avid WWE Online player from like 07 until like 2011, shout out to this game for starting it all. See, at the end of the day, I can't hate on this game. I know this game gets kind of forgotten and it's not perfect, but I can't hate on it because, like I said, it's still fun. I mean, any game that has a similar gameplay to Here Comes the Pain will always be fun. You can still do wacky, crazy stuff, jump off ladders, do insane Hell in a Cell matches, and you still got a great season mode with SmackDown and Raw storylines. Yeah, the roster is lacking, and there weren't any big new additions to the game, but I can't blame them. It was a transition year. SmackDown vs. Raw 2006 was going to be that big jump, and it was that big jump. They still added some cool mechanics, the game still looks great, it feels authentic, and at the end of the day, it's a good time. They could have easily pulled a Madden and given the exact same game from Here Comes the Pain with somehow even worse season mode and taken out half the match types and then brought them back the next year to make it look like they added some crazy features. But luckily they only took out the backstage areas and just, you know, minor stuff. So it could have been much worse. This game isn't bad. It's not WrestleMania 21 or anything like that. The best way to describe this game is that the game showed potential and it laid the groundwork for the future SmackDown games that are so beloved, like 06 and 07. See, this is a game that you can still have fun playing today with your friends or with yourself. And it did have one of the most fire soundtracks in video game history. And like I said, it also started a series we loved. So SVR 06 and 07 are amazing games, and they came after this, and they were built on top of this. So I just can't hate on it. Plus, it was following up Here Comes the Pain. You know how hard it is to follow up something that amazing? So is it amazing? Nah. Is it trash? Far from it. It's a solid, solid wrestling game.